than appreciate privilege of strolling outside, meeting friends and loved ones in whom we can confide. Nature walks and kids at the park seeking while others go hide. The firm grip of a handshake or a warm hug have now become memories. Don't talk about public affection or a kiss, now leak into a viper's hiss. The world as we know it has become a wonder to behold. Adventure with anticipated sceneries have now become stories to be told. Like Eskimos, our world has become cold, confided in our cocoons. Oh, sorry, homes. Since the consequence of going outside is worse than swimming in the chilling waters of Antarctica, this is what is happening. These are not just words of a metaphorical thinker. We used to think that we had it all together, cruising through life smoother than leather. Where is our power, money and notoriety that we often brag about? The medical science and 2 billion brain cells still can't figure out that we on our own have always been vulnerable. Both the commoner and the honorable, the young and the old, no one is immune to a microscopical yet lethal enemy which has ravaged what is known as the human species. These are not just lines about doom and gloom, but thought-provoking words as you sit in your room, that we should contemplate our vulnerability, not only that we be of response but responsibility, like warriors wage war not only scientifically, but with our knees on the floor in humility, realizing that there is a higher and infinite power and a person who resides in every molecule of the atmosphere, and it's more powerful than the pangs of fear, with the capability of not only healing, but wiping out every tear, and it's relatively a whisper away. Dear humanity, let's pray.